Hello friends, let's begin with parametric and constraint based modeling. Parametric modeling. In a parametric solid modeling, the solid objects are described mathematically in three-dimensional space by the parametric equation as shown in the figure. The solid object is represented as an assembly of non-overlapping hyperpatches as shown in the figure. So it is a non-overlapping hyperpatches. So those are connected together and it's a formulated a parametric form. So figure shows that the Cartesian and parametric representation of hyperpatches. The parametric solid modeling was originally developed for the purpose of finite element analysis modeling. Nowadays, in addition to finite element analysis, it is also widely used in applications such as computer animation, composite material modeling, and mass property calculation. So, here we can write the equation as like this. P of U, V, W is equal to X, Y, Z, where X will be depend on U, V, W. Y will be depend on again UVW and Z will be depend on UVW. But remember, X is another coordinate for the U as it is a parameter. Y will be for V and Z will be for W. And all the parameters are having limit X minimum, X maximum. Similarly, here also limit U minimum, U maximum. For Y direction, V minimum, V maximum, and for Z direction, W minimum, W maximum. It is always lies in between there. Okay. That is a parametric equation. So, constraint based modeling, more than a procedure, one procedure, and the database can be used to arrive at the same domain. That means the constraint based modeling is having multiple procedures are there for a same geometry. Basically, it's having two types that relates only part, entities, or to 2D sketch. Then, dimensional that is related to size, location of entity. So, for example, this is the original and it is having axis. When we see around the axis the mirror condition, that time we get a mirror like this, mirror of original object. So H will be changed, automatically changed. That will be for similar size of the or similar part of the object. Okay, on both the sides. So that mirror is one of the commands. Parallelity, perpendicularity, then coincident, tangent, concentric, equal radius, distance between, angle between radius. These are the considerations of geometric. This is the constraint based modeling. Okay, so what are the constraint and without applying the constraint and with applying the constraint, what are the changes? These are the taken from one of the books of CAD/CAM automation from RV Patil from Pune University Technical Publication or Technical Publication. Okay, so here coincident is nothing but A and B. The two points having different location, they are having a coincident. This point merged together. Okay. Collinear means they have two lines where non-collinear condition. Now it is on the one particular sequence line. So this is the ACBD conditions are there. So it is a collinear. Then concentric, when two circles having different center, now the two centers having same. Horizontal, if inclined line becomes horizontal. If inclined line becomes vertical, then vertical. Or midpoint, if a line having a any point within that line, that point should be a mid position, so it will consider as a mid point. If two lines are parallel, not parallel condition, that time we can make it parallel. Similarly, perpendicular condition are there, then tangency. If two circles are not in tangent position, we can make it tangent position. Or circle line tangent also we can get it. For symmetry purpose also we can manage the symmetric half. Thank you so much. Hope you understand very well.